So we're sitting here with the Argues, Canada's family band, and if we could have everybody introduce themselves, and we'll start from the left, and you are?
Chantel Argue.
And what do you play, Chantel?
I play the drums.
Okay, and who's to your right there?
I'm Sabrina Argue, and I play the keyboards and lead vocals.
Okay, and?
I'm Lauren Argue, and I play the bass and vocals.
Lead vocals.
Okay.
Well, we're having an argument here. We're the Argues. I'm Michael Argue, and I'm responsible for this whole thing.
Michael, when did the whole concept of the band start? When did it take place? When did you actually say, you know, to Chantel, let's do a band? Or is that how it happened?
Well, it kind of just fell all together because me and Chantel always played together, guitars, and then the girls came along and we noticed they could sing quite early. And
now, how early?
Well, I remember playing some Chuck Berry songs with Lauren. Alice Cooper songs.
You were playing Alice Cooper with your daughter?
Well, she loves that. She's 18. I've got some videos.
I have footage of Lauren at about 18 months to 2 years singing, I'm 18.
Really?
Yes. Months. I'm 18. She's singing it. Michael's playing lead.
Yeah. Now, it's interesting that you would play an Alice Cooper song to your first daughter. Is that what your influences are, that 60s, 70s rock?
Yes. Definitely. A lot of that music, definitely.
Really? Yeah. Now, is it because you were raised on that, Sabrina and Lauren, that you heard dad and mom play Alice Cooper and
yes.
classic rock yeah. and that kind of thing? Yeah. Now, do you still listen to that stuff
yes,
now?
Yes, that's pretty much all we listen to.
Well, we listen to a lot of different music, but that's pretty much the basis of what we listen to.
Okay, now what would Sabrina, what would you listen to that's new and current today?
Well, I don't listen to much that's current today.
So you're not like Justin Bieber or anything like that? No? What about you, Lauren? Do you like somebody like Justin Bieber or Rihanna or...
Well, I prefer the older music.
Really? Process take? Did you do it like in a week or?
The actual tracking, we did that in one day?
Two days.
Yeah, so we had the setup, and half day we did tracking, and the second day we did the tracking, and then we came back and did the vocals for one day, and then, or an afternoon, and then we did a bit of mixing for a half a day.
Okay.
So four days probably in total.
Okay. 4 days in total.
Yeah.
Now, all the songs have a real big hook to them. Who came up with the basis of all these songs? Was it the whole family, or is one or more person, like Lauren, did you come up with some of the riffs of some of the songs before anybody else?
Well, when I do my bass line, like I write my bass line, and we kind of all incorporate into the songs our parts of them.
Okay, so how does it start out, Chantel? How does the song start? Does it start with guitar? Like, do you and Michael and the girls, do you write song on guitar, like at the cottage, and then bring it back and put drums and bass and keyboard to it, or how does it work?
How the songs start is almost different every time, because all four of us write.
Okay.
And we might start with lyric, we might start with a groove, a sound. I generally write on guitar myself.
Okay.
Sabrina has written on piano and guitar, so there's some variation there. And sometimes we could finish a song ourselves or we give it to someone else, and it could be any one of us or all four. I sometimes give my stuff to Lauren and say, you know, come up with something to go with that. And if she's got an inspiration for it, great, then we have a co-write. If not, you know, someone else gets a kick at the can. And sometimes it happens when we're actually arranging. We start changing words, changing the sound, and then we're all co-writers on it. And so it's really different every time. And what's happened is we've evolved since we started last year in our songwriting and how we do it. So we're excited to go back up north this summer and go at it again.
Speak a second ago about the cottage. Can you tell us about the private island you guys own up north, a little bit about that? Because that's really where you structured the first album, right?
Yeah.
Can you give us a bit of a description of what the island is, what it means to you guys, and what is on the island?
Okay.
Well, there's a lot of interesting things on the island. When we first went there, there was about, how many snakes?
55.
50, a lot of snakes.
50, 60 snakes on there, yes. We got an old log cabin, about 100 years old, really dilapidated.
Sure.
And it was in rough shape.
And it had about 100 bats.
At least 100.
Some bats and snakes.
Bats and snakes, yeah.
The snakes were feeding on the bats. It was a very environmental situation.
Really, there was a lot of stuff happening on there.
So what did you do? You just turned it over, you renovated. You made a little nest for yourselves on this island?
Yes, we did. We had the old log cabin torn down, and we built a new cabin there, about 700 square feet. And it's built it ourselves over about a 2.5 year period.
So it was a family project.
Yes.
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 The first year, we thought we'd actually just renovate the cabin and couldn't because it was so infested with bats. So we stayed in the bunkie, a little 10 by 10 bunkie. Yep. The second year, we tore all the structures on the island down. So we slept in a tent for the second year. And then the third year, we had the log cabin started. And so we could, you know, sleep in that. And so it's been an evolution. Every year has been a totally different experience. So
now, do you find that you write music better up north or in Toronto? What's your preferable site, Lauren, for example?
Well, preferably up north, because I guess up there's not many distractions, so we have more time to think. And yeah.
Is that where the song The Boy came from?
Yes, we wrote
it. Is there an actual boy that you wrote about? Like,
Well, when we go on the Georgian Bay, we see a lot of them. And so I guess that kind of inspired us to write it.
Yeah.
you've actually attracted some serious attention from a Juno Award-winning songwriter and Hall of Fame inductee, Tom Cochran. Sabrina, can you tell me a little bit about you meeting Tom Cochran? What was it like?
Well, so I had a backstage pass to a World Vision concert, and Tom Cochran was playing there. And it was really great meeting him. He was really nice, and he had recognized me from the, we did a cover song of No Regrets.
Yeah.
And he really liked it.
Did he give you any advice, Sabrina, Lauren, Michael, Chantel? Like, did you have time to talk to him about, you know, the music business or that kind of thing?
Well, I spoke to him very briefly. I spoke to him about the log cabin. He was quite interested.
I bet he would be.
Yes, he's up in that area as well.
Sure.
And Sabrina did get some business advice from him. Go ahead, tell him Mark about it.
Well,
what did Tom tell you, Sabrina?
Well, he told me pretty much that I was good. I don't really remember him like saying advice.
Well, didn't he give me some, said you could replace him?
He said if he got laryngitis, I could replace him.
Isn't that interesting, you know?
Help him out, I guess.
Because I know Tom's bass player, Jeff Jones. Yes. Jeff has actually been to Image before, and he played some guitar actually just right over there. Uh-huh. Tom's a great guy. His music is, there's like four or five in Canada, right? You think of Shania Twain, Bryan Adams, Tom Cochran, Red Ryder, Rush, right? There's a whole handful. It must have been really special for you guys to actually hang with him a bit. And, you know, and we posted the No Regrets video about 4 or 5 days ago as a teaser for the HD concert we're about to put together. And he actually likes the new video too. So, did you want to say something to Tom?
Well, thank you.
Thanks, Tom. Yeah, thanks for writing that song, because we loved it. We played it, and it was a great honor meeting you.
I had the great pleasure of meeting Tom Cochran, and this song goes out to you, Tom.